What happened?
Hot diggity dog! This place is magnificent.
Okay, let's learn how to make Martian bases for my Necron army. Welcome, my friends, to my tutorial on how to craft and paint Martian-themed Warhammer 40k bases. Today, I wanted to share with you my simple step-by-step process on how to create immersive bases that will transport your minis to the red sands of Mars. First, let's gather the materials. One detail, I do this before priming. You'll need texture for the Martian surface. I use Vallejo Earth texture, and sometimes some cork to add some high ground. You can use any texture you like, or even sand and small rocks to create an uneven surface. We will also need two shades of orange, one for the base coat and one for the highlighting with dry brushing. For bringing out the details, Agrax or shade, but any dark shade will do. I haven't tried darker, so if you do, tell me how it goes. I use Vallejo Airbrush Primer, but you can do what you want for this step. I just prefer black. Last key element, I use Green Stuff World Light Orange Oxide Pigment for the cherry on top. It adds a very dusty feeling and I use it to blend the miniature and the base together. If you don't have any equivalent, you can do this step with dry brushing more. I was inspired to go for Martian bases for my Necron army because of the movie Mission to Mars. Sorry. Childhood memories, I can't help it.
Oh my god.
For this step, I'll demonstrate on a Scorpec destroyer that I built the wrong way. I dip an old cheap brush in water, then take a generous amount of texture. Don't be cheap here. You need a fair amount to sell the effect. Spread it on the whole base, then tap gently to create small uneven cracks. Don't be afraid to put some on the foot of the mini, or any scenery that goes with it. It helps blend the mini with the base. This is the right time to add small rocks or any other element to your base. Remove any excess on the edges and let it dry for a few hours. Doing this in batch is very smart.
Okay. Okay. Please work.
For this step, I use Vallejo Orange Fire, or Citadel Fire Dragon Bright, mixed with a bit of black. Dilute your paint and spread it on the whole base. You can add a second layer if needed, especially on the parts that are more exposed to light. This is where it gets interesting. Apply your wash everywhere without ruining the details. So be generous, but don't hesitate to go back and remove any excess with a clean brush. This step is very satisfying because it brings out the details.
It's so someone would be left to figure out the secret. Just come.
Next, let's bring out even more details with dry brushing. I use Fire Dragon Bright for this and a dry brush palette. After humidifying my brush just a little, I use it on the dry brush palette and on my hand. Cover the whole base and even the lower parts of the minis. Imagine walking with a cape and large boots on the surface of Mars. It must be messy, and I picture a rising cloud of red particles. That's my opinion, but you do you. Do as you like, I don't mind.
This is where it feels like cheating for me.
You can skip this step by doing step 4 multiple times and on the lower parts of the mini. With a cheap old brush, I apply the pigment on multiple spots of the base. I then try to go up on the lower parts of the mini, in this case the legs. Then, shake off the excess by tapping gently. You can even blow on it, don't worry, it sticks. I just simply paint the edges black with my primer to hide any messy previous operations or airbrush work. I sometimes see people overlooking this step on any base design, and I don't understand why. It just helps with the general finished look of the mini. But again, you do you, I don't mind. On the necrons, I really like how the orange pigment transforms the metallics. It helps telling a story. Your mini is not just standing there, it was working before and got dirty, and all you see is a frozen moment of its existence. And there you have it. With just a few simple materials and techniques, this is how I create immersive Martian themed bases for my Warhammer 40k Necrons. I hope you found this tutorial helpful and inspiring. Tell me how it goes in the comments, and until next time, happy painting!